You are tuned to FM Gold Channel of All India Radio, Delhi. To celebrate the spirit of sports and Olympic Games, we are continuing with the next episode of our special series entitled The Saga of Olympics, Past to the Present by Nitish Arora.
जीत को अंजाम दे।
एक खिलाड़ी दुनिया के किसी कोने में हाथ में तिरंगा लेकर के दौड़ता है, सारे हिंदुस्तान में ऊर्जा भर देता है।
वहाँ एथलीट्स दम लगाएंगे, आप यहाँ से हौसला बढ़ाओ। Cheer for India.
The much awaited Tokyo Olympic Games are going to start tomorrow and countdown to the Olympic Games is a torch relay which is one of the most important feature of any Olympic Games. The Tokyo leg of the torch relay started 15 days leading up to the opening ceremony. That is tomorrow, the torch relay passed through the 23 wards of central Tokyo. Some of the sites the torch visited in its journey include Minami Tama, where the regeneration of the Tama new town community is underway. Nishitama, with its expansive forests and the fresh waters of the Tama River, and Kitama, where the hills stretch outward from the residential areas. The torch relay also travel across the waters to Tokyo Islands, from the Izu Islands to the World Natural Heritage Site of the Ogasawara Islands. The Olympic flame visited all the municipalities, each offering unique scenery, marine resources, special goods, and many other treasures. The second half of the torch relay saw the torch pass through various areas of urban Tokyo, including Ginza and Nihonobashi, the center of Japan's economy and commerce, Roppongi, the shopping and entertainment district, and Shinjuku with its skyscrapers that shoot towards the sky. And now we move on to the Indian contingent for the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. The Indian contingent in Tokyo will be participating across 18 events. We start with archery, wherein we have the world champion Deepika Kumari. The 27-year-old Deepika Kumari is from Ranchi and is in fine form after winning 3 gold medals at the recently concluding 2021 Paris World Cup. The other members of the team are Tarundeep Rai, Atanu Das and Praveen Jadhav. They all will be representing the men's team. Moving on to athletics, Tokyo 2020 will see India field 27 athletes in track and field events. And the biggest hope still remains Neeraj Chopra. He was the gold medalist at the Asian Games in 2018 and Commonwealth Games 2018 in javelin throw. Shivpal Singh is another contender in javelin throw. The other athletes from the men's contingent include Amol Jacob, Rajiv Arokia, Muhammad Anas, Naganathan Pandey and Noh Nirmal Tom. This is the team for 4 into 400 meter relay. We also have Avinash Sable for 300 meter steeplechase, MP Jabir for 400 meter hurdles, M. Shri Shankar for long jump, Tajinder Pal Singh Tour has qualified for short put, Sandeep Kumar and Rahul Ruhela for 20 kilometer walk and Gurpreet Singh for 50 kilometer walk. We also have a strong women's contingent comprising of Jyoti Chand for 100 meters and 200 meters, Kamalpreet Kaur and Seema Antil Punya for discus throw, Anurani has qualified for javelin throw for women, and Bhavna Jat and Priyanka Goswami for 20 kilometer walk. India will also be fielding a team for the 4 into 400 mixed relay comprising of Sarthak Bambari, Alex Anthony, Revati Virmani, Subha Venkateshan and Dhanalakshmi Shekhar. Badminton will be one of the most keenly watched sports at the Olympics for India. And this time around, India will be pinning its medal hopes on the 4-member team comprising of B. Sai Praneet, who will be competing in men's singles, P.V. Sindhu competing in women's singles, Satvik Sairaj, Ranika Reddy and Chirag Shetty will be participating in men's doubles. We have quite a few hopes from our pugilists in Tokyo Olympics. The flag bearer for this Olympics and 5-time world amateur boxing champion Mary Kom is one of the most inspiring athletes for India, and she will also be competing in the Tokyo Olympics. This time she will be competing in the 51 kg category. And the other member of the team, boxing, who will be joining her to go for glory would be Simranjeet Kaur. She will be competing in 60 kg category. Lovlina Borgohain for 69 kg and Pooja Rani for 75 kg. The men's contingent includes Amit Fangal in 52 kg, Manish Kaushik 63 kg, Vikas Krishnan in 69 kg and Ashish Kumar 75 kg and Satish Kumar 91 plus kilograms. Fawad Mirza will be participating in equestrian. This is followed by fencing, and we have C.A. Bhavani Devi participating in fencing competition sabre event. We have a participation in golf also, and the team includes Anirban Lahari, Udayan Main and 23-year-old Aditi Ashok. Golf is followed by gymnastics, and India will be pinning all its hope on 26-year-old Paraniti Nayak. India dominated the hockey scene at Olympics from 1928 to 1956 with 6 successive gold medals. Ranked 4th in the world, the current team looks like it can take on to the best and will look to end the 31-year-old medal drought at Tokyo Olympic Games. And the squad include P.R. Srijesh, Harmanpreet Singh, Rupinder Pal Singh, Surendra Kumar, Amit Rohidas, Birendra Lakra, Hardik Singh, Manpreet Singh, Vivek Sagar Prasad, Neelkant Sharma, Sumit, Shamsher Singh, Dilpreet Singh, Gurjant Singh, Lalit Kumar Upadhyay and Mandeep Singh. The Indian women hockey team is also expecting a podium finish, and we have Savita as goalkeeper, Deep Grace Ikka, Nikki Pradhan, Gurjeet Kaur, Udita, Nisha Meha, Sushila Chanu, Pukhrambam, Monika, Navjot Kaur, Salima Tate, Rani, Navneet Kaur, Laliram Siami, Vandana Kataria and Sharmila Devi. In judo, Sushila Devi and Likma Bum in the women extra light weight 48 kg category will be representing India. We have Arjun Jute and Arvind Singh in men's lightweight double sculls for rowing, and Vishnu Shravan, KC Ganapati, Varun Takkar and Nethram Kumanan for sailing. Shooting is the sport which we have to look for, and for the men's shooting squad, we have Divyan Singh Panwar and Deepak Kumar for 10-meter air rifle, Saurabh Chaudhary and Abhishek Verma for 10-meter air pistol, Sanjeev Rajput and Aishwarya Pratap Singh Tomar for 50-meter rifle 3 position, Angad Veer Singh Bajwa and Mairaj Ahmed Khan for skeet. Women's squad is represented by Manu Bhakar and Yashashwini Singh Deswal for 10-meter air pistol, Apurvi Chandela and Elvinil Valarivan for 10-meter air rifle, Manu Bhakar and Rahi Sornabath for 25-meter sports pistol, Anju Mudgil and Tejeshwini Savan 50-meter rifle 3 position. For 10-meter air rifle mixed squad, we have Divyansh Singh Panwar and Elavinil Valarivam, Deepak Kumar and Anjum Modgil. 10-meter air pistol mixed squad, we have Saurabh Chaudhary and Manu Bhakar, Abhishek Verma and Yashaswini Singh Deswal. Sajjan Prakash has qualified for 200-meter butterfly, and Srihari Nataraj has qualified for 100-meter backstroke for swimming in men's category. And in women's squad, we have Mana Patel for 100-meter backstroke. In table tennis, we are represented by Sharath Kamal and G. Sathin, Manika Batra and Sutrita Mukherjee. In tennis, we are represented by Sania Mirza and Ankita Raina. And only a few days ago, Sumit Nagal also made himself eligible for men's single tennis participation at Tokyo. We have a very strong contender for weightlifting in Mirabal Chanu. Finally, wrestling is another event at which India will be hoping to bag quite a few medals. Bajrang Punia and Vinesh Fogart are two medal hopefuls for India. The other wrestlers in men's squad include Ravi Kumar Dahiya and Deepak Punia. Vinesh Fogart will be representing India. Seema Bisla, Anshu Malik and Sonam Malik. That completes our squad for the Tokyo Olympics. And keep your fingers crossed, because India is going for glory, as they are aiming for a double-digit medal count for Tokyo 2020.
You just heard the next episode of our special series, The Saga of Olympics, Past to the Present, by Nitish Arora. This broadcast came to you on the FM Gold channel of All India Radio, Delhi. Please stand by for the next broadcast.